I'm Dr. Davapalani Alagappan, Head of Emergency Department at Apollo Hospitals, Greens Road, Chennai. And these are extraordinary times. And lots of people do suffer from their emergencies. Those with chronic diseases, those with real health emergencies, all of them are quite a bit lost. They're lost about where to gain access, when to gain access to healthcare. And as a result, we are seeing lots of patients coming to us quite delayed. And there are several reports from across the globe, particularly from the United States and Western Europe, where they are seeing the non-COVID deaths and the morbidities from non-COVID emergencies are much higher than the COVID deaths in themselves. So this is very worrying. Say, what do we mean by these non-COVID emergencies and morbidities and deaths related to that? So we're seeing patients with acute heart attacks, patients with acute strokes, patients with infections, etc., coming to the hospital pretty late. So I would like to recall a few instances of where the results didn't go as planned. We had a 50-year-old woman who had chest pain for nearly 16 to 18 hours before she decided to access our emergency department to get help from our emergency department. She's been having central chest and upper abdominal discomfort, and she's been taking Gelicil at home, an antacid at home. Obviously, when the symptoms didn't get better, she got to us. So it didn't take long for us to diagnose her with a heart attack, but then precious time was lost. Most of the time critical emergencies, we have a narrow window to offer them appropriate care and rewarding care. In her case, the myocardial damage was significant and she had started having fluid buildup in her chest as well. We did subject her to angioplasty, open her blocked coronaries up, but then the results wouldn't have been what it would have been when we did it straight away. Say, had she presented to us within an hour or two, things could have been very different for her. So this is not just a one-off. We've had many, many MIs presenting to us after complications much later. So we've also had patients this morning who we had a gentleman with infections. So he had a long-standing infection of his leg, lower leg. And this gentleman had been seeking some local remedies, taking antibiotics on his own, etc., but obviously didn't have the desired result. So he had the infection having spread to his bloodstream. He had very low blood pressure, felt very dizzy, was clammy, wasn't looking good at all when he came to us. So he had a huge necrotic area, dead tissue in his lower leg. And he had kidney impairment from the infection as well. So he suffered from what we call sepsis with multi-organ failure. So this gentleman is currently in our department. And he's delayed seeking care, emergency care, for a very long time. He's put it off by nearly 10 days. So he's been taking local antibiotics, some simple dressings, etc. It didn't help that he was a diabetic as well. So he is, we are trying to do what best we can, but he is quite ill. So these are some examples of people not responding as they would to a health emergency. So there are many factors which prevent them from doing so. Not all hospitals are admitting patients. Access in terms of transport, etc., to healthcare facilities is a problem. So all these are, and generally people are reluctant as well, that if they go to a hospital they might acquire unwanted infections, specifically corona virus infection. So but the truth is, in our department and at Apollo, we take utmost care by using gloves, masks, and appropriate personal protective equipment, and we try and segregate as best as we can patients who have a suspected corona infection, and we keep them isolated and we treat the others in a different area. So we do our best in terms of all these. But despite all of that, people are very reluctant to reach hospitals, and particularly for health emergencies, time critical emergencies, it's really taking its toll on the outcomes. There are many who have presented to us late. We've had patients who've been brought dead to us on arrival, say patients who missed dialysis, patients who had chest pain for days and days, patients who thought their breathlessness will get better with inhalers, etc. So we've had quite a few with all of these, and they have ultimately come to us at a stage where we were able to help them very little or not help at all. So the biggest message here is that if they do have health emergencies, they need to be reaching out to hospitals, and they need to be reaching out to hospitals sooner. So we've also had, so that the corona infection per se is presenting in very, many different forms other than just fever and respiratory embarrassment. So it presents with, there's an increased risk of cardiac damage, increased risk of strokes and other thrombotic events, and all of these could be quite perplexing. So the bottom line is, if people are suffering from any health emergency, and if they are not really sure as to what's going on, they need to be reaching out to the hospital. So this is with regards to how we can approach the health emergencies. Another important thing is we need to really realize the end is not really, the end of the game is not near by any chance. With no vaccines on the anvil, on the horizon, and with no specific treatments that are workable solutions for the corona infection, It's going to drag on. So we need to be prepared for the long haul, and we need to, so ignoring seeking medical help for other health emergencies is not really an option. So we have to really learn to live with the virus, at least for the next few months it seems to be the case, till we have an effective treatment or a vaccine which becomes available. We don't see the vaccine coming up for a good few months. And similarly, several treatments are being tried, but none of them are effective. Everything is experimental so far. So we'll just have to hope an effective treatment gets identified. So there are many patients other than the COVID infection related presentations who have lots of other problems. So all of them can seek out to hospitals. The Tamil Nadu government has given the permission to open up hospitals for non-emergencies. They have identified hospitals which are earmarked for COVID treatment, and they have identified other hospitals which can treat non-COVID infection, non-COVID emergencies and other health ailments. So people should seek out treatments, particularly with time critical emergencies. So the elderly in particular, I know they are vulnerable with multiple medical problems, and age is a factor with coronavirus as well. The elderly do particularly poorly when they acquire a COVID infection. But with regards to reaching out to the hospital with a health emergency, they seem to be the one who seems to be bearing the brunt of it. We had a 70-year-old gentleman who was on multiple medications. He had some medication-related problems. His sodium level dropped. He was on lots of cardiac medications, and he was on diuretics, and his sodium level had dropped. The family had decided to wait till his conscious state was really, really low, and he was nearly comatose before they could bring him up. It was a quick fix. We had to stop the medication and correct his sodium carefully, and he came around. But then he was very nearly in, at the verge of having had some irreversible damage. So these are, I've already given you so many examples where seeking health care is being put off for all the reasons explained, or just from the fear of not wanting to go to hospitals. I think people should fight these. This is not going to end anytime soon. And the lockdowns are being brought in to help spread of the infection, but nevertheless, we don't know. The numbers keep increasing, and we may be in it for a good few months. The end doesn't seem to be anywhere closer. So we just have to decide. We'll have to get on with it. And people with other health emergencies should reach hospitals sooner. With regards to the kind of case mixes that we see, we are seeing increasing number of people with what we call thromboembolic phenomenon. We are having increasing number of people with pulmonary embolism, with heart ailments, cardiac ailments, and people with stroke. So these seem to be increasing in number, but till we have a proper analysis of all the data, we wouldn't know if they are all COVID related. So far all those presentations have tested negative for COVID infection, but the worldwide data tells us that thromboembolic events are higher in people with COVID infections. I would like to end with a clear message that if there is a true health emergency, we would like people to seek out adequately equipped healthcare facilities. We at Greens Road Apollo are open, and we take appropriate precautions, we hope people do reach out to us on time. Thank you. I'm going to take some questions. Thank you all for listening, and good day to all of you.